This is bar power stretch. You'll need something to hold on to and a mat or something soft to work out on. Lifting up and bending down. And as you come down, think inner thigh stretch. Lift down an inch, up an inch. Good. Down, up. Back out. Standing inner thigh stretch again. Reach it out. Maybe you're a little bit deeper this time. Maybe you're up a little bit higher. That's totally fine. This is a very dynamic, active stretch that will help you open the inner thigh muscles. Down. Excellent. Now we're going to be still and hold right here. Hold and be still and just feel the body changing here. Inhale, relax your face. Bend the back knee and if you can, raise this heel up. That's just gonna make it more challenging. And we'll just bend down a few inches and up. Good, bend down a few inches. Now I want you to focus on feeling the stretch in your hip flexors, which is right here. Good, press it up. So you'll feel your glutes really activating here, both sides. Two, and then one. Again, just slowly lower down. This is advanced active stretch. Leg straight, keep the front knee above the ankle, and if you can, raise the torso up until you feel a stretch in your hip flexors. Now take the back elbow to the outside of the front thigh into a spine twist. Look over the front shoulder. You press your arm into your knee, outer knee, and the knee into the arm to create resistance. Two. It's a tiny little pulse, barely visible. On one, press it up, arms release. Reach it to the floor. Try to straighten this leg if you have the flexibility to. Keep it soft if you need to. Raise the top leg as much as you can. Pulse up four times. Step the back leg back. You're in a plank position. Press the floor away. Now take your hips back and then walk your feet in a little bit if you need to. And I want you to just pedal the heels here, pressing the heels down one at a time toward the floor. So walk the feet back, the foot back. And then if you want to, you can increase the stretch by bringing the shin more parallel to the top edge of your mat. Hands are down, arms are strong. Pick the body up, square off your hips. Stay upright if you need to. And then inch your way back behind you. If you can, getting closer, but staying square in your hips, and that's the most important part. Two. Up, three. This is deep. Four. This is your lower body stretch. You'll need something to work out on, like a mat, and something to hold on to. You also wanna make sure that you're warm, so you can walk for 5 to 10 minutes, or you can add this on to another exercise routine. And one more breath out, good. And then release that. And then shift it back and you'll carefully take hold of your support and let's stack shoulders over hips, hips over back knee. Square off, flex your foot. Good, and then we'll start to hinge forward. And again, we're not hinging forward from the upper back, we're hinging forward from the pelvis. And just give me a little shimmy side to side. Good, excellent. Now back into that center point, really lift up, maybe look up toward the ceiling. And then you can hold here, especially if you're a little tighter in your hips, or you can move into the full expression of triangle, which is shin on top of shin. So we'll bring the legs down. And then you may also wiggle the toes on top, find that foot, and walk the body in that direction. And take a few deep breaths in. Just open up these muscles right deep in the pelvis. And we're gonna go ahead and stop, press the knees down, open your feet like a book. And then if you can, lift the chest and come forward. And you'll feel a stretch here, maybe you're in your calves right here or in the bottoms of the feet, then stay here. Now if you feel like you could move on, we're going to lift the knees off the floor. Good, and then I want you to shift back so that your hips go toward the mat, but they're not fully on the mat and your knees are lifting. This is upper body stretch. You'll need a mat or something soft to work out on and a band or a belt for one of the stretches. And you also want to make sure that you're warm. And then come forward and you can either place your knees down or you can keep your knees lifted with your legs straight and extend the spine again. Up. And from here, use this hand in the front as leverage to really twist your shoulders, trying to stack your shoulders here. And you'll feel a stretch all the way down your spine into the back shoulder blade muscles. Excellent, and then we'll go to the back. So release it and reach that arm back. Really walk the hand out. Breathe in and out. Take your left ear to your left shoulder as you really hold your collarbone in its place. And you're going to just tilt your head around until, so you can just gaze up at the ceiling and then lift your chin. This side of your chin lifts up so that you can stretch out the neck muscles here. And if I release the band a bit, I can go a little bit further and just hold the stretch here. You'll need a band for this relaxation stretch. Sit. And then prop the toes forward and back. Go ahead and let the spine twist by lifting the hip off of the floor. That back arm just reaches out in line with the shoulder. Circle the feet in the opposite direction. Pump the feet and wiggle the toes. Gently release the back leg straight down below you and twist more to the back. You can increase that stretch by gently encouraging with the back fingertips. This is a stretch with a ball. You want to make sure that you're warm before beginning this. You'll need a ball, any size will do because we will not be sitting on it, and something to work out on. Press, tuck your toes, lift the leg. You can hold the ball here or you can reach it forward through the arm. Reach it out and then just move your ball forward and back, and then hold it forward right there and really stretch out through your lats, which is the outer back. Forward and roll the ball back. And each time we go forward, I just want you to go a tiny little bit further if it feels good and if you can.